welcome to this very new episode of Brain and Spine Surgery. I am Dr. Jaydev Panchawagh on behalf of Synapse Brain and Spine Foundation. And today I will be talking with you about endoscopic discectomy. So many of my patients have requested me to make a video about this technique, and here it is. Endoscopic discectomy, in short, in nutshell, is a procedure in which a small endoscope is passed to the place where there is a slip disc, and that slip disc portion, that is the slipped portion of the disc which is pressing on the nerve, is removed through the endoscope. And normally it is a stitchless surgery, or at the most one has to take a single stitch if there is too much fat in a given patient. So I will like to show this procedure with the help of the illustrations here. So this is a case of a young patient who came to our spine center with complaints of severe right-sided sciatica. He complained of severe pain starting from his low back and going into his right thigh, right calf and right foot, and it was becoming unbearable for him to lead normal life because of this pain. If you see his MRI here, you can see a prolapsed disc at the level of L4 and L5, that is, this is in the lumbar region or low back region. And if you carefully see here, there is a nerve, a thread like nerve, which is getting severely compressed or pressed by this herniated portion. If you look at this disc, which is normal, you will see that this is a normal disc architecture, there is no prolapse or herniation, but here the central portion of the disc is slipped back and is literally rammed into the nerve that is going to his thigh, and that is why he was getting this severe pain. Now, in endoscopic discectomy, we have to remember that it can either be done under local anesthesia or general anesthesia. In his case, he chose local anesthesia, so we numbed that portion which we were going to incise. This is another view of the MRI, which is showing a disc prolapse. You can see this convex portion, that is a disc which is not supposed to be here, and it has prolapsed inside. So in his case, as I was saying, this procedure was done under local anesthesia, and a small needle was passed under the X-ray or fluoroscopic guidance in his L4 and L5 disc space at the desired level. So this initial placement of the needle is very crucial, and it has to be absolutely accurate. And over this needle, we pass the dilators and then the channel through which the endoscope is passed. So you can see a very, very small channel that is passed over the needle, and the needle is now removed. And this portion we have numbed with local anesthesia, so the patient is not aware of anything going on here. Now, endoscope, which is roughly of the diameter of a fountain pen, is passed through this channel to the place where there is a disc prolapse. And as you can see, that we are operating with a big forceps here, which is passed inside through the endoscope channel, and the culprit fragment of the disc is removed. The large fragment which was pressing, as we saw in the MRI, it was pressing on the nerve, and here you can see a small hole through which this fragment had entered. And you can actually see, if you very carefully focus here, you will see a nerve which is now decompressed, and the fragment was entering into the spinal canal and pressing on the nerve through this small hole. And after the surgery, I have taken this photograph to show how this fragment, which was pressing, looks after the removal. You can see this white fragment here and a corresponding preoperative MRI picture here. After the surgery, he was made to walk within 30 minutes, and he was completely pain-free. And actually, it is more than 5 years down the line after his surgery, he is still completely pain-free. And in his case, endoscopic discectomy was certainly very, very successful. So coming back to a very important question, which many of my patients ask before surgery, of course, is whether endoscopic discectomy can be done in their case. The answer is that not all cases of sciatica and not all cases of disc prolapse can be and should be treated with endoscopic discectomy, because the reason behind sciatica in every case is different. Having said this, it is very important to remember that the cases which actually are amenable to endoscopic discectomy should definitely be given this choice. And a good spinal surgeon or a good neurosurgeon operating on spine should be able to offer all these three, all these choices depending on a particular case. So, as we saw in this case, in this particular person, endoscopic discectomy was possible and indicated and was useful. We may get a case in which there is a similar symptom of sciatica on the right side, but there is slipping of one vertebra over the other, which is called a spondylolisthesis. And in that case, if you do endoscopic discectomy, not only will it be a failure, but the person's symptoms will increase, because there will be further slippage of one vertebra over the other. So, in that case, you have to perform what is called a spinal fixation along with removal of the compression on the nerve causing sciatica. So, this is the answer in short about endoscopic discectomy. I have made a detailed video on surgery of endoscopic discectomy, which you can see in my channel. Please subscribe to this channel so that you can see new videos on various spinal problems and brain problems. Thank you very much again for watching this video, and do visit us again. Thank you.